Biografija jednog psa je knjiga koja je pisana u prvom licu. Pisana je zbog toga što sam htjela da kažem ono šta bi jedan kućni ljubimac imao da kaže za svoju ulogu kućnog ljubimca, koja se znatno razlikuje od onoga što bi imao da kaže vlasnik.
Okay, the novel, the biography of one dog is a book written in the first person, so that is the sense about the role of one dog, and it is significantly different from the role of owner, pet owner. So that's the difference between two of them, and that is the book about.
How did you come up with the title and content of this book?
Kako ste došli na ideju za sadržaj i za naziv knjige?
Srela sam jednog psa i pogledali smo se direktno u oči i ja sam u njegovim očima videla molbu da napišem sve ono što bi on želeo da kaže. I ja sam evo obećala njemu i to i uradila, tako da sada imamo knjigu Biografija jednog psa.
I met one dog and he looked me straight in the eyes, so I saw in his eyes what he wants to say, and I just passed it on to the paper. So now we have a novel, a dog's biography, or biography of one dog.
What was your writing process?
Kakav vam je bio proces
pisanja? Ja inače pišem brzo i lako i iznad svega pišem iskreno.
Okay, I write quickly, easily and above everything sincere, honestly.
Did you face any challenges while writing the book?
Da li ste se prošli s nekim izazovima kad ste napisali knjigu?
Mislim da sam napisala sve ono što je taj pas želeo da ja napišem i to sam videla u emocijama njegovim iz njegovih oči.
I think that I succeeded in writing everything that dog wanted me to tell to the people, and I think that I have managed to do that because I saw that in his eyes and I sensed his feelings.
Is there any real life character that inspired you to write this book?
Zagma pravi izazov,
yes, koji je vas ispisao da napišete. Da, ima dosta izazova iz života i ja sam veliki broj svojih knjiga napisala upravo o istinitim događajima, obzirom da sam ja advokat, kroz moju advokatsku praksu je prošlo mnogo interesantnih životnih priča i ja sam mnoge od njih stavila na papir, jer ono što život ume da režira, to retko koji reditelj ume. Pored toga bila sam i upravnik muškog zatvora, dva zatvora, i tu je bilo mnogo teških sudbina i ja sam se potrudila da neke od njih također stavim na papir, ali sada pričamo o dečjoj literaturi.
Okay. She said that there's always a lot of experience needed for writing a book and plenty of emotions that are needed to be passed on the paper. So she thinks that she succeeded to do that, and all of her stories are written by real characters. She is a lawyer by profession, and she has many of her characters written about
you. What kind of responses have you received so far?
Kakve ste sve utiske do sada dobili, pozitivne negativne kritike?
Kritike vezane za knjige ili
za knjige?
Pa to ostavljam kritičarima da komentarišu, a do sada su svi bili dobri, inače bi me to, da su bili loši, to bi me obeshrabrilo. Kada su dobri, to ti da krila.
Okay, that also motivated her to write better and to write stronger, and because all her critics were great and because of that she has written numerous books.
Your future plan and what are you looking for?
Vaš budući plan I čemu se nadate I radujete naprijed?
Moj plan za budućnost je da pišem I dalje I da promovišem knjigu, da deca što više čitaju, jer mislim da bi ovu planetu trebalo malo vratiti unazad, jer mislim da se zaukala nekim pogrešnim kolosekom. A to se može dobrom knjigom I tekako vratiti.
Okay, her plan is to write and write, because she thinks that many children today do not read enough, and that this planet is running too fast, so that it could escape from the railway. And because of that, she's trying to write better, so that the children could read and enjoy in her books.
Key takeaways for the readers.
Neke savjete za pisce. Za pisce I za čitaoce.
Za pisci I za čitaoce. Čitaoci neka čitaju, a pisci neka pišu. Svako ima svoj stil I svakoga je neka tema odabrala. Ja sam, na primjer, zahvalna svim temama koje su odabrale baš mene. Mogle su naći lepše, više, pametnije pisce, ali evo, odabrale su baš mene. I posebno sam zahvalna biografiji jednog psa što je odabrala baš mene.
Okay. She is so grateful that her teams have chosen her for their writer and they could choose a better, younger, more beautiful writers. But they have chosen her and she told us that readers should read and writers should write, and that's the point of the whole story.
What advice do you have for other writers?
Kakav savjet imate konkretan za pisce?
Konkretno rekla sam da svako osluškuje život, da vidi da li je on odabran, da neku priču stavi u korice knjige. A onda, naravno, apelujem na izdavače da to prepoznaju I to ponude deci kako bi ova planeta napravila korak napred.
She told us that writers should recognize some theme that is good for them and to put it between the covers of one book, and publishers should also recognize and see the quality of those writers and their books, and to publish so that it could be available for the young readers and it could be available all around the world.
Dakle, biografija jednog psa u Kyoto.
So, the biography of one dog, or the dog's biography, thank you for your attention.
Hvala.